It's 5:15. Welcome back, folks. On tonight's Be Green 2, we learn about sustainable flowers, and this may be of interest to you who have a brown thumb.
Mm-hmm. Kirk Matthews found out you may just want to have a wet thumb.
Back in Waimanalo, up against the Ko'olau's, Geobunga is growing water lilies. And according to owner Andrew Dedrick, it's not that hard.
You know, when we're talking about the flowers, sustainable flowers, and talking about water lilies, it's that flower that gives year-round. It blooms weekly, and it's really easy to take care of. You can forget to water it for a month. It's still going to be out there.
The water lily is a complete ecosystem once you add the mosquito fish. They are an important part of how the lily grows and flourishes.
When you get a lily at Geobunga, we give you all the fish you want. We just ask that you don't feed the fish. You know, we want to strike a nice little balanced ecosystem. The fish go in the water. Any mosquitoes that land, they'll take care of the mosquitoes.
Again, don't feed the fish. They'll be fine. If you feed them, according to Dedrick, they get lazy and don't do their job. It might be a little scary to put a pot of water on your deck, but Dedrick says don't worry, you will have fewer mosquitoes than your neighbors. And the variety of lilies is amazing.
There's about 38 different varieties or cultivars that we have out here in the water lilies. We have hardies and tropicals and night bloomers. We have those night bloomers for the people who, you know, they get off of work at 5 o'clock, don't get home till 6, and that's about what time the night bloomers are opening up.
There is a reason he refers to water lilies as sustainable.
Well, your lily will actually last forever, basically. Lilies have been around since the days of the dinosaurs, so they'll be in your garden as long as you have your home.
Dedrick says the lilies are easy to propagate, so you can give some to your friends and neighbors, and if they've been around as long as the dinosaurs, that's good enough for me. Kirk Matthews, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.